Study Mama here with a Bible study minute, and we're going to be in the book of Hebrews chapter 12. So I'm going to turn there today. As I do, I want to encourage you to like, subscribe, share, tell your friends, share this on your Facebook page or wherever it is that you connect with people online. And I would love to see comments too about what God is speaking to you. I'd love to read through those and just hear what God has been doing in your life, what he's been sharing with you. And so I'd love for you to join my community here on YouTube. We are in our Bibles, Hebrews 12, verse 1, and it says this: "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance." Can I hear you say endurance? "The race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured." Can I hear you say endure? "The cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God." This verse comes right after Hebrews 11, where we see story after story after story of men and women of the faith in Scripture who lived out their faith, who walked in radical obedience, who are those we call the heroes of faith today. People like Abraham, who went out into the unknown, and Moses, who led the people out of Egypt and into the promised land. Noah, who radically obeyed God and built a boat in the middle of the desert. Abel, who gave a good sacrifice. Jacob, who worshiped even on his deathbed. We see all these people: David and Samuel, Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, Sarah, who believed that God was faithful and was able to conceive a child in her old age. I mean, we see story after story after story, all of them witnesses, all of them evidence, all of them proof that if we will not give up and we will endure, it is worth it. It is worth it. But have you ever just had a really hard day? Have you ever just had a day where you felt like giving up was the best option? Have you ever just had a messy day, just a really messy, broken day? Or how about a really tired day where you are exhausted, your eyes are burning, the coffee is doing nothing to help you stay awake, and you are just fighting for every inch of that day? You know what? Their stories have all of that too. There are giants they had to face, armies they had to fight. There's infertility, there's death, there's loss, there's struggle, there's poverty, there's hardship, there's question marks, there's unsure moments. They faced all of those things too, and yet they made it. And yet they made it. And so it says now that we are surrounded by all this evidence, all of this proof that we can make it. Let us lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that was set before us. I love what Peter says in Scripture. He says, add to your faith endurance, and you're going to have to. You're going to have to. You're going to have this enduring faith. You're going to have to add to your faith endurance if you are ever going to make it through this life, through all the hard stuff, through all the messy bits, through all the broken places that come with this life. You're going to have endurance. And I love in verse 2 of chapter 12, it says, looking to Jesus. Looking to Jesus. And mamas, that's what we need to do. We need to look to Jesus. That is where our faith will be secure. It will be founded as we look to him. Recently, my husband and I were asked to do some really radical things, and God's been calling us to this place of obedience where he's telling us to step out of where we were and kind of go into these big question marks. Like, we have no clue why we're doing what we're doing. We have no clue where God is calling us to go. We have no clue what he's calling us to do. We just know he said to be obedient. And so we stepped out. But then after we started stepping out and following him in obedience in these certain areas of our lives, all of a sudden the question marks started to feel really big to me. And I started to feel overwhelmed and I started to feel afraid and I started to backpedal. I started to go, know if I can do this, God, you know? And in the midst of that, I went to God and I said, God, I just feel like Abraham. I feel like I'm going out into the unknown and I have no clue what is going on. And he stopped me. And God spoke so clearly to my heart. And he said, Nikki, quit looking at what you don't know. And I want you to look at what you do know. And so he started a list. What do I know? I know that God has always been faithful to us. I know that he has kept every promise he's made to us. I know he has fulfilled every word that he's spoken. I know that he's provided for us. I know that he has sustained us when it didn't look like we would make it to another paycheck and God would be faithful. I know that he has blessed us. I know that he has walked with us through really hard places. And when our child was in the hospital, as we went through adoption processes, we went through all these things. I know God was there. He was with us. He was always available. And I just began writing this list out. And before long, my heart is exploding, not afraid anymore of those question marks, but filled with anticipation because I realized it wasn't unknown. Sure, I may not know exactly where we're going, but I know who's taking us there, but I know who's leading us. And there was this peace that settled into my heart and an endurance that was added to my faith to keep going, to keep trusting, to keep believing, even in the midst of not knowing exactly where we were going. So I want to encourage you today, wherever you are, maybe you're having a great day. Maybe you woke up exhausted. Maybe you're going through a really hard time, or maybe it's just been a really messy, overwhelming day. Can I encourage you to stop right now and look to Jesus? Begin to make a list of what you know about him. And look at that list every time and keep adding to that list every time you feel like giving up, you feel like throwing in the towel, you feel like you're not going to make it and you just can't take another step. And I encourage you, bookmark Hebrews 11 and read it over and over again. And remember that each of those stories are stories of real people who went through real stuff. They went through real stuff, real messes, real broken places, real hard things, real battles, and they overcame. And you will too, as you put your faith in God, as you look to him, and you add to your faith endurance.